See the difference. They say that the total eclipse will be here on the United States, so we will see if that is correct. I placed two cameras here to see how the eclipse will look like from both positions. So in order to draw the correct distance to the sun and moon, I had to come to this website that calculates the distances of any day you want. So this website gave me the distances to the sun and moon. Now let me show you what I drew in space. Here is the sun, and the lines you see represent the umbra and penumbra three positions of the moon. And here is the moon in three positions. This moon is in the same line of the sun, and this one is at 11 degree latitude, and the other one is at 12 degree latitude. All of them are in the same distance that I got from the website that I just showed you. But you see them like that just because they are not on the same axis. And again, I draw three moons because their latitude degrees have changed in one day. I wanted to do three possibilities just in case, okay? The umbra of this moon is these two blue lines, and it ends right here, too far away from the Earth. And that is problem number one. The umbra should reach the Earth. But according to the distances they give us, it doesn't reach the Earth. So the eclipse should happen in space where this red line is. The red line, by the way, is the line between the center of the moon and the center of the sun. Okay? And the umbra of the second moon is these two red lines, and it doesn't reach the Earth either. So the umbra of this moon should also be seen in space. The last moon, as I said before, was just made up by me, because that is one of the right positions to see the total eclipse. It is exactly between the Earth and the Sun on the same line. The umbra is the same, too far away from Earth. Let me zoom in so you can see things better. The total eclipse should happen right here. So I put a camera here so you can see it from Earth. Now I'm gonna click on it. Hold on a second, let me change this to realistic so you guys can have a better view. Well, there you go. The two moons on the right were put there based on mooncalc calculations. And it's not possible to see an eclipse from this viewpoint. And the moon on the left is the moon that I added myself on the same line so you guys can see the eclipse if it's really going to be caused by the moon. This is how they should set their calculations so the eclipse can happen. Not on the USA, but on the ocean of south of Mexico. If they want it to happen on the USA, then they should change the position of the moon completely. But even if they do this, they will still have a few problems. Look at the moon, it looks way smaller than the sun and not the same size as they will show us. Therefore, they should change the distance to the moon and make it shorter, or make the distance to the sun longer. Now check this out. If we move 1 degree to the left, the total eclipse would be a partial eclipse. Imagine how it would look like from the USA if they leave the moon where it is. According to the Globe Earth model's calculations, none of the three moons should give USA a total eclipse, even the one that I made up. This is what they say. The total eclipse will only happen on that red line. If you are on the blue lines, you will not see 100% total eclipse, but it will be a 99% total eclipse. And I just put a camera on that line to show you how the eclipse would look like according to the globe model. This is how it would look like. None up there, two moons on the right would be near the sun. And the third moon on the left that I made up myself is also not a total eclipse. It is a partial eclipse from the USA. If the moon would ever make it to that position under the sun that I just made up, then the total eclipse would be on Mexico and not on USA. But if we rely on their calculations only, there will be no eclipse at all at that exact time. So if the globe model does USA, but if we rely on their calculations only, there will be no eclipse at all at that exact time. So if the globe model does predict the eclipse, we will know and this would work, but it didn't work because the globe model doesn't predict the eclipse at all. They rely on someone who retired to tell them where the eclipse is going to happen, guys. So this should tell you three things. One, their model is wrong and they are using something else to predict things. Two, the moon doesn't cause a solar eclipse. Three, the earth is not a globe. Now before you go, let me show you how our flat earth model predicts the eclipse without adjusting anything. It was made like this long time ago and it's still like this. And no, I'm not saying that the map we are using is the flat earth map. We're just using it for now because it works pretty fine with the things we do. As you can see, the shadow of the moon is exactly about the USA. Do they use the flat earth model to predict the eclipse? I don't know. Please don't forget to leave me a comment and tell me what you think. Thanks for watching.